Nu är nya Kazumo.com här. Just nu får du dubbelt på kontot och 110 gratis chanser att vinna storkovan. Kazumo, ett kasino. Kazumo.com.
Vi borde pränta böcker ännu till slut.
Pantomera. Du kan rädda världen. Bara gå till affären.
Gör som Tumba pingpong. Pantamera. Gör som Tumba pingpong. Pantamera.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Those adverts are amazing. They've done such a good job. All right, we're here. It's Ramon Firing. It's the Inferno Online Pantomera qualifier. That's going to lead into the main tournament happening on the 7th. It's going to be a lot of fun at Inferno Online. And as you can tell, there's a bunch of cool teams coming. Fnatic, Virtus Pro, NIP Titan, and Team Envy, which is so cool, right? Former LDLC team, but now picked up by the NVS organization. And we need to find one more team, as you can tell that way, right above me. We're missing a qualifying team. And it's going to be one of the four tonight. So glad you guys want to join us. And with me, I do have...
I've got Semrana three...
Vendetta. What's up?
Oh. Yo!
At some
well,
point...
Just, you know...
At some point, I need to just unmute and listen to the conversation and hope that you have, like, a really, really awkward one. Because it would be funny.
Oh, we had some dirty deets going on right now, but you kind of spoiled it for yourself.
Yeah, exactly, dude. You could have sat in here and listened to the entire Norwegian strategy, right? And then, you know, everybody... Well,
failure.
Norwegian. I mean, it's like a 10 Norwegian team going on right now still, but...
Complete failure. All right, well, next time I will be more careful. The other team that's playing here is Playing Ducks, the German team, and also Elsinore, which is actually a Finnish team with that features mainly people I don't recognize, except maybe one or two. But yeah, and Playing Ducks, I know them pretty well, so maybe we'll see them later on. It's two best of three games tonight, guys. So right now it's the two Norwegian teams, and following afterwards, the winners are going to play the winners in a final, and the winner of that gets to qualify for the tournament. So that's how it is. Semra and Vendetta, you guys feeling ready? Are you on the GoTV and everything is working?
Yeah, everything's yep. Really working fine. A little choppy on the GoTV, but hopefully that'll smooth itself out as we progress.
I'm sure it will. There's always something, right?
It can't all run smooth, right, Anders? I mean, this is still CS after all.
It's still CS, it's still online, it's always something. But in case you don't know, if you're not from Sweden, maybe you don't know what Pantomera is. And it's actually an organization that promotes recycling, as you maybe could have guessed from the intro video. And their adverts are hilarious. They're so good. Having like good adverts is really, really rare, but I love them. I'm almost tempted to like just play them every once in a while, even outside of this tournament, because they're so funny. But we'll see how that goes. So definitely go and give them some feedback as well. Tell them that you enjoy them being in esports. They do actually have a Twitter account as well, I mean, who would have thought that a Swedish recycling company would have a Twitter account, but they do. So that's at Pantamera. I'm going to find the line now and see if I can't just link it in the chat because or somebody else do it because I think mine. There we go. Yeah, so follow them on Twitter right away, guys. Definitely do that. A nice way to give them a little bit something back. At Pantamera like that, spelled correctly and everything. So go and follow them on Twitter if you haven't already. And show them a little bit of love because it's really cool. This is actually a significant tournament. I mean, LAN finals, 25,000 euro. That's pretty nuts. Like, that's a lot of money for something that takes one day.
It ain't too shabby, that's for sure. I don't think any of the teams going there are gonna be unhappy about the prize pool.
No, the fact that the prize pool got so high is actually, I think, going to give us better games because now teams are actually going to Stockholm to boot camp early before this. Like Titan,
they came
straight from Finland to Stockholm. They're on the same flight as us, and they're just sitting over at Inferno boot camping. So it's like that's sick.
They decided to. And you mean it makes sense, doesn't it? Instead of traveling from Helsinki to back to France, then just like stay in Stockholm, which is such a nice city anyway. You wanna be there. So.
And you know, speaking of boot camping, that this is something I just saw earlier today. I'm not sure if you guys saw this, but Kaboom, they've decided to stay in the U.S. to boot camp in Denver, I think, yeah, in order to be able to go to the Katowice qualifiers.
Now, I think, Ven, just before we move on, I think your microphone is a little bit louder than everybody else's. So I think if you could, can you turn yours down a little bit? I think that's going to work out.
All right.
I think Semler, let us know in the chat, guys. Semler, I think yours is all right at this point. Yeah, Vendetta's okay. Mic, yeah. All right, so just...
Now, cross your fingers, guys. Cross your fingers, because for some weird reason, I turned on the PC today, and I left the Yeti mic plugged into it, and the light came on.
Damn.
So, I don't know if it's, like, been resurrected or something, but I'm on the Yeti mic right now, so hopefully that's going to be a bit better mic quality as well for everybody tuning in.
All right. Well, continue to give us feedback, guys, in the chat, and we will we'll definitely, you know, sort it out along the way. If there's any kind of, you know, volume issues, we'll take a look at it. But apart from that, we should be live pretty soon. So I will actually switch it on over to the game just so that we know what is going on here. And yeah, it's a best of three game coming up. But you're right, Kaboom. They managed to stay in Denver, which is really cool. I actually spoke with Fallen yesterday. And a little bit today as well, just to figure out how much money is that they're missing and what could we potentially do to try and help them out. Because I feel like, as far as I can tell, that they're lacking a good $12,000 or something like that. Which sounds like a lot. Certainly, if you had to pay that yourself, that'd be painful. But I'm pretty sure as like a community as a whole, we should be able to figure something out. I can't imagine that. Like, it would be really, really sad if that was the only reason why they couldn't go. So, can't make any promises yet, but I feel like we should look into it, at least see if we can't do something about it. That would be good fun. So yeah, we'll see. We'll
some
see.
Some kind of donation account,
right? Something, right? It's if everyone donates like $5, then you know they're instantly going to go. And the thing is, if they qualify, it's actually cheaper for them to stay in Poland from the qualifier until Katowice than it is to go home. So they would actually potentially have like a whole month where they could boot camp in Europe, which would also be so like it'd be so valuable for them. So. It just feels like it's meant to be, in my opinion.
Mm. You gotta be careful about that extended boot camp, though.
Yeah.
Like, a month, you know, it doesn't sound like a lot, but in reality, it is actually a lot of time to spend, like, in one place with your team, on the road, in a hotel.
But it's very similar to what Made in Brazil did back in the day. They basically just, you know, travel from Brazil and stay in Europe for quite some time, practicing, you know, in between events. So it's kind of cool that we're seeing a similar thing with Kaboom right now, and I really hope it works out for them, and I definitely hope that they qualify for the event in Poland.
Yeah, me too. And here's what's really, really important to recognize is that even if, let's say we get the money to get to send them to Poland, let's say they don't qualify, and that doesn't mean the money's wasted at all. That's still really valuable information. So don't, like, this isn't like the community paying and then they have to qualify, otherwise they've let us down. That's not how it works, guys. So just keep it in mind. We'll spread some more info about it later on. Now, it's the Inferno Online Pantamera tournament right here. It's the qualifiers, LGB versus Agent. And Agent, they are Synex, Ultra, Netgo, and I'm not sure that last guy's using his real name, Ben.
Fetchke? Yeah. Alright, yeah, that's the Swede, so, you know, don't be surprised by his silly nickname, right?
Alright.
And, it's actually Neto G, or like Neto G.
All right. Well,
not Netog.
All right. We'll go with Neto at this point then. Sevis, though, he's waiting in B hallways from the LGB team, joined by Polly, who's back in the team instead of Enza, Rain, Jakim, and Rubino, and the game is already on. Firing away. Jakim gonna take down Cynex early on, and a nice headshot from Sevis to take down Cy. Finally, the terrorist team replying just a little bit here. Getka coming in, but he's gonna go down as well. Rain with a good headshot, and Jakim picking up three kills, and I think they were all headshots. So not much chance to introduce here, because the action was on pretty quick, and it did not work out too well for Agent.
Not at all. Sevis obviously spotting out a big part of the Agent team that early, and that aggressively in B apps made the rotation very easy for LGB, especially when Agent made it so evident that they were actually committing to the B bomb site.
Well, I mean, I think everyone can tell that LGB are the favorite team here, but do you know not much about the other Norwegian players, those who aren't Swedish on the Agent team?
Oh yeah, for sure. Ultra is obviously probably the most known player out of all of them for everyone outside of Norway, simply because he played at SWC with the old Agent lineup. So he's been around the block for quite some time, and all of them are fairly known players around in Norway. Obviously, they've never played at the highest level in Norway, but you know, they've been around, and everybody inside of Norway knows who they are. And Cynex is probably one of the up-and-coming talents. He's a young guy who's been putting a lot of time into CS. So it's cool to see him having a team that's actually doing pretty all right.
I'm pretty surprised to see Polly jumping up to an M4 right now, spending the money on it. I would have expected him to try and rush an AWP on CT Mirage. That's a fun little tidbit there to pick up.
I think that's partly because they know that they're up against another eco.
Yeah,
so no chance of extra risking it.
I guess it could be. Well, they're not risking much this round at all, because they're getting all the kills in there. Last round was actually pretty decent from Agent. Shame they didn't get the bomb down, but they got two kills inside that B bomb site. So, I mean, something was accomplished anyway. Now they're going to go all in on the AKs. Ultra could go for an AWP if he wanted to. I'm not sure who is hoping for this team, but just thinking about it for a second and then goes back to the AK armor. It would have been without armor as well, so that's always a little bit scary. And so that means no orbs at all in play just yet, which is all right. You don't have to do it on Mirage. It's just become sort of a standard thing.
Rifle teams across the board, pretty much. But this is going to even it out at least. Rubino's about to take a peek into two waiting T's. We're pushing up underpass. I like that Agent went as a pair together. So if that fight did happen, they would be able to trade. Scythe did take a lot of damage in the trade, and Polly's going to look and see if he can't actually pick up the return, and he's going to get it. So, LGB in the end will get the man advantage in this scenario.
Right, they're going to smoke off apps as well, making it significantly more difficult for Neto to do anything at all. Ultra will pick up a kill, and now it's back into a 3-on-3, looking actually pretty decent. Rain, though, will take him down coming up with Connector. If he could have stayed alive in Connector, maybe he could have distracted the remaining CTs from the fact that there were a couple of people sneaking in from the other side. But they're still trading kills fairly well here, the Agent team. They could actually win this round.
It's possible. I mean, Polly's alive on Electric Stairs right now. He's looking... I'm just going to call him Electric Stairs. But Zevez waiting in CT spawn is going to deny that plant. And it all comes down now to Neto. And he's not going to be able to get out of the apartments with Polly playing from that position. So, pretty clean work in this sense. Well, actually, no, not really clean work at all. Just messed up positioning coming in on LGB side, I think. Jakim getting caught out, just completely flanked. I think he thought he had a teammate watching Connector, which is why he was in the position he was in. And also, I believe Rain running out of bullets with the spray down on his second target, not getting the job done there. So a little bumpy here, actually, for LGB. I think they should be able to tighten up their game a little bit more than what we're seeing right now.
It looked a little bit looked like there was some disconnect with them pushing
discombobulated
in. Something. A lot of Tech Nines, though. I think we'll just move on to that for now, and I'll learn how to speak again later. It's going to be Polly, Rubino. Actually, Polly picking up both those kills. I thought Rubino was going to help out then. Looking a little bit confused on Electric Stairs, you said, Semler. Scythe now in Connector, and it's him and Fjetke left, but they've actually done a significant amount of damage. Tech Nines, man, they're so good, and they get the bomb down as well. This is a huge success.
That run and gun.
Fjetke, man, he's so close here, and they're stepping a lot on the other side. They put down the smoke, but oh, that would have been one-shot range with the Tech Nine. Jakim, though, gonna take down the last remaining players. But what do you think, Ven? That was a good round from Agent.
Yeah, not so good round from Rubino, I think. he was kind of half a second behind everything that was going on that entire round, and eventually ended up with no bullets and two people in his space with the Tech 9. So it didn't work out too well for him in the end. But in the end, they do get, you know, another round, and Agent would have been able to buy up in this round anyway. So it's not a huge loss for LGB, but obviously you need to sharpen up things if you want to play this safe.
We are going to go into a standard A round. And I mean, I don't blame them. When you had that much success with the Tech Nines, why not just try and see if you can't smoke off and actually, all they have to do is kill Rain and they probably win this round. That sounds easy enough, except the fact that it's Rain and he's already hiding in the smoke, trying to see if he can just buy time for his teammates to come in here. But he dies in the fire that was put down. Actually, he did some damage initially, but now the bomb is down. The only saving grace here, Semla, could be Rubino from behind. He's going to die to Ultra. I cursed him.
I think you did, bro. Whoa! Nice shot there by Scythe as well, holding off Jacob. Jacob pretty much caught out on a limb there. And this is now the two remaining members here for LGB trying to close in. Drop down shot from Zevez, and Polly putting that off to good use. Zevez using the Tech 9. And oh, he doesn't get the second frag. I thought for a second there was going to be some kind of form of like poetic justice going on there. Zevez walking in and just getting two kills with the Tech 9. How sweet would that have been?
Good stuff from Fjetke at the end there. That could have actually been really, really scary. I think that was a 2-on-4 at the end almost, Ven, and they almost lost that round.
Yeah, 2-on-4. Solid attempt at a retake from Polly and Sebas, but obviously it wasn't quite enough, and that was mainly due to the fact that the three first members going down for LGB barely did any damage to the Agent team. Agent got a pretty easy way up onto site due to a good A execute.
Well, they're going to attempt B again this time, and they actually have some set smokes as well. I think one of them might be for the window, so they're already going to be going in here, and Jacob trying to get a couple of crossover kills. How did he kill two of the pistols out as well? It's now a triple kill for Jacob, and he has plenty of time to reload here. Backup's coming in, and Fjetke, well, he's pretty far away. Can't really do much at this point in this 1-on-3. They have the bomb as well. That was an unreal round from Jacob.
Yeah, he has a tendency to do that every now and again. He's probably the most exciting player that you're going to see from Norway this year. Because I just assume that people know about Rain by now.
That was going to be my follow-up question. What about Rain? What about Rain?
Alright, Rain is still probably the best player, or no, he is the best player in Norway, but Jacob is gunning for that title, I think. It's going to be exciting to see how he does versus the top competition.
Oh, wow, look at that. That second flick onto Jacob, just as you guys were cursing him, there's pretty much no way you can survive the round at that point, but that was a really insane AK shot, but it just wasn't enough. I mean, using a 1-on-3, surprised he even got that much out of the round. So 6-1 is going to be the scoreline, and Agent are still without much of an economy.
Well, that's what you get for winning that one round and losing without building any consecutive rounds for yourself. But they do have Tech 9s, and they did do a pretty solid job last time around. They had Tech 9s, managed to get a bomb plant, and I think it was 3 kills in total. Mm-hmm. So, you know, there's definitely room for them to do something and do severe damage to LGB, because LGB are pretty poor themselves.
And I like the decision. Just go for a smoke round. They had success. Like you said, you know, last time around that they went for this play, it worked out pretty well. This time around, however, it looks like LGB are in a bit better positions, and before I can even finish that sentence, they completely annihilate Agent's push coming out of T-Ramp there. So there you have it. You know, it works one time. It doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be as successful the next time around.
Yeah.
I kind of get the sense that whatever we're trying to highlight at this point is just getting shut down instantly.
Right? I'm afraid. I don't know what to say anymore.
Well, this is some interesting Norwegian Counter Strike. I can't remember the last time. I don't think for like this is like 6 months. I don't think we've ever seen 8 rounds on Mirage without anybody buying an AWP. So that's interesting. Rubino gonna take down Cynix coming in first, and there's a really big presence here for the LGB team as they're pretty much all rotating in. Jacob and Polly chiming in, but Fjetke doing a really good job, just trying to see if he can get some kills in. That grenade actually blew him almost into Severs at the end there. And then Neto gonna go down to Jacob. Really tough position from him once again at the end. So, I mean, LGB are rotating really, really fast. They were almost 4 people on the bomb side by the time that Agent had even made it out of A ramp.
I think that was actually a really lucky nade, because that saved Jacob's life pretty much. If Jacob doesn't get that nade from Zevez to kill his opponent, he's just spraying with the USPS. He probably gets taken out there pretty quickly, and then we could be looking at Agent with a man on the site, and that can change things. So nice nade there by Zevez, basically to save save his teammate and pretty much save the round there for LGB.
You know, sometimes you just need a little bit of luck, and it'll go your way. And there is the AWP. Polly picks it up. The Polymorph, as he calls it. So I'm happy to see that. Agent waiting patiently for the smoke to go away. And that smoke actually is really bad, the one that Polly just threw, because it's not going to cover everything. Sevez, I think, realizes and, well, he gets the one kill in, but I think he wanted a lot more from that M4. Now Polly's got to be careful here. If he commits fully to holding, he could get overwhelmed. Backup is coming quick, though, so now it's all right. But up until that point, you've really got to make up your mind if you want to fight or just wait for backup. Sipe can't really do much. He's going to go down. No bomb plant. How many bombs have they had down this game, Ven, so far? Has it been like two or something in the first 10 rounds?
I think it's only been... Yeah, it's been two. The one eco round and the round that they won.
Yeah. That's not
cool. So, yeah. Well, they've gotten to the sites quite a few times, but... As you said earlier, LGB are doing a good job of rotating early, and I think that's mainly because they realize that Agent are not faking a lot. They're kind of just committing right away.
This time they try and get control of top mid, but it's just not working out. LGB are pretty much everywhere, and it is the classic setup, and the reason why I was initially confused by the lack of an AWP, once it's in the window here and Polly's shooting, they come out and they cleverly flash themselves in, but they already lost one just peeking top mid. And then they have the full focus on top mid, and I think it was Jacob who was waiting really, really close to them on the ramp. And then, you know, they lost a couple of people there as well. Such a simple trick.
I think the biggest reason for the absence of the op early on was simply because LGB did a pretty wonky job of actually holding on to their weapons during the anti-eco rounds, and they didn't have the opportunity to actually stabilize their economy.
Well, things are looking better for them now, although, just as I say that, Ultras can actually win the fight against Rubino, who seems to be a little bit cold. Usually he's a little bit more on point, I would say. Rain to take down Kefir, and it's down to Synex and Ultra. Ultra is going to be alone, and he actually dies before he can even switch to him there. Jacob to take the last kill. It's 11-1. We did kind of agree that LGB were the favorite team here, but this is starting to get very much out of control for Agent.
Wow, I'm impressed that Agent in this scenario actually decided to go for an eco.
Restraint?
Yeah, showing restraint, really. I mean, that takes some courage as well when you're so far behind to decide not to go for a force buy. Just be like, okay, we need to get rounds on the board, guys. Let's go for a force buy. They're like, okay, we're actually comfortable with potentially only getting three rounds out of this. That's scary right here. They're in a pretty difficult position, and they're going for an underpass play. Are they going to try and catch somebody off guard here? Who is in position? It's Polly in window, and he's only got the AWP.
Last time Polly jumped down, if he did it again, certainly they'd be able to kill him. But he's going to show some restraint, and Rain, not that many bullets for a lot of kills. He's only going to get the two of them. And Tech9 fighting against Polly up in the window here, but backup's coming as well. Jacob going to put an end to that circus, which has put us right into the 14th round.
I think the break that Polly has taken, or at least that there's been in Polly's career, has helped him. Or at least, I don't know, it's a lot to say off of one map, right? But I'm really impressed with Polly's level right now. He's hitting some pretty clean shots. 17-1-4, that's a really big scoreline. Or perhaps it's the fact that he isn't calling, that it's Zevez that's calling. Maybe that pressure off of his shoulders has really allowed him to step up and start landing those kills.
It's probably a good mixture of things. I think at the end of LC, really, most of their players were kind of growing tired of just playing because there were so many issues they ran into. I mean, for the last 3 months they played, they barely got the same lineup 2 days in a row for official games. And that does wear on your motivation to play, so definitely think that tiny break he had actually did him a lot of good.
Rain. Gonna rain fire onto Fjetkir and end up taking him down, which is a big blow because now the bomb is sort of back on A ramp, someone has to come and get it, and I think that's going to be Sight. But in the meantime, they've also wasted a lot of time, and there's still, well, there's at least a Molotov on Polly, and Jakim, oh, he's over at the B bomb site. So if they try and come through here, I mean, putting down the bomb in the A bomb site, it's not always easy. Even once you've killed the CTs that are in there, you can end up having prolonged fights, and they really don't have time for those fights anymore. Now they kind of just have to make it work. Rubino pushing up a dark. you know, just carrying on that LGB name a little bit, even though it's a different lineup. Rain inside, waiting with the M4, takes down the bomb carrier as well, and now the backup is coming in. Polly will go down, though. Great grenade from Neto.
Great push overall of the Patience, but it's still getting worn down to a 2-on-2. Scythe lands a crucial shot on Jacob right there, and now it is going to be down to Zev as the last man alive. At least he's close on electric stairs, but he still has to be worried. There's a man waiting below him, and he doesn't spot Ultra in time. And he just assassinates him with that AWP up close. So two rounds there for Agent. Two rounds. Are they going to get that third one that they gambled on?
I think they kind of have to if they want to keep any sort of hope alive going into the second half. Even though they're going to be on the more favorable side, it's still, you know, a mountain the size of Mount Everest for them to climb.
Yeah, it is looking really rough. But one good round is definitely better than none. Rubino, though, flashing himself onto Synex, and that's just a very, very neat trick. It's all about timing, and, you know, you could do it a couple of rounds in a row and never find anyone there, but the one round where you do, it is kind of hard as a terrorist. You tend to get a little bit too complacent and forget that they actually can get to that corner at underpass really fast.
Look at this push coming in from Zelviz. He's going to be out at top mid from B Apartments. This is looking real good. There's two guys gathered up top mid as well, and he turns away at the worst possible time. He could have had a free kill there.
Well, he still has a lot of information, but you're right. That would have been a horrendous raid for Agent. Just as they were trying to set up, they'd end up losing it. Thing is, Fiatka's the one carrying the bomb, so if Zevis gets this kill on him, that means the bomb is suddenly lost in a really bad spot, and I'm not sure he hasn't heard. I thought he would. Neto going to open up. Zevis, he's well walked through the smoke, and there's Rubino inside, waiting to pick up the kill. Neto almost going down. In fact, he will die to Rubino as well. And now I think they realize, wait a minute, we were being backstabbed the whole time. They're all here, but Ultra is still alive, but only with 27 seconds in this one-on-one.
No, Zevis. Patience. Patience is key at this point. He knows he's facing an AWP. He hears the steps, and there you go. Bait has been taken. Now it's going to be about Zevis just landing the perfect shot here. He's got the incendiary grenade. He's probably just waiting for that. Can he use it to get him out into the open?
Oh, Ultra! Not going to let him play that game. That was actually a very, very nice 1v2 for Ultra. I'm impressed by that. So 12-3, that much is accomplished, Vendetta. I mean, maybe they just took a really long time getting into warming up in the game here.
Yeah, might have been it. I honestly think Zevis should have had that round. I think he played it actually too safe in that sense. If he plays closer up into the pit right there, then he has a potential of actually punishing, or at least seeing what's going on the second Ultra picks up the bomb. But he took a bit too much distance for that to work out.
Well, they are going to try for the B rush just like Agent did. Agent now defending instead, and Scythe trying to get a kill. He's only got the one so far. This is working out way better for the LGB team on the terrorist side. In fact, they're pretty much picking up all the kills at the end here. Getco seems to be the top fragger on Agent, though seems to be the top player currently. Isn't equipped to handle this 1v4 at all. He's being stabbed in the back as well. Sever's gonna put an end to it. Yeah, he's got the 12 kills, which is not at all bad. But if it wasn't already the end of this first map here for Agent, it probably is now.
Yeah, we're gonna have to see some eco heroism coming out of the Swedish Norwegian lineup if they're gonna if they're gonna have any shot at this. But it looks really grim right about now.
I still like the fact that Agent don't decide to go for a force buy, risk it with a force buy in this round. Instead, they're going to force it up next round when they have FAMASs.
Yeah, that's definitely a good choice.
Oh, what? And a Tech 9 losing versus a USP? What is going on?
All right, so we just got something established in that 1v1 fight, which is that crab walking is better than Tech 9s. Because he crab walk with a USP. I've never seen anyone do that before. You have to be an absolute heretic to decide to do that. Like, yeah, Rubina. Just on the verge, like the next step up from crab walking with USPS is probably worshipping Satan just in public. That's bad. That's very bad.
There was a time where crab walking was super effective. Actually, someone who's really good at doing like crab walking-ish tendencies while spraying is Rain. He's ridiculous at it.
The people who actually are good at crab walking make it really effective. It's so annoying. That's why I'm saying it's bad. It's because
it's an evil thing to do.
It's so evil.
You guys are making it sound like they're lighting kittens on fire or something here.
That's not far off.
That's the next thing. That's the next thing that will happen. Sipe goes down. Ultra goes down. It's Severs and Polly, and actually just the whole LGB opening up the middle. And generally speaking, if you're the terrorist team rushing into the middle like that, if you don't use a bunch of smokes and flashbangs, you're going to get, you know, just out-angled. There's going to be so many angles you get attacked from that you'll die. But they were pretty decisive about getting the entry frags that the CTs couldn't even attempt to hold middle. And now, Netko, I mean, he's really going to have to show some sick crab walking to get out of this situation.
Now, I'm very happy to see just how confident LGB are right now moving across the map.
Yeah.
Oh, and there's the early swap, so I guess there was no comeback there.
Yeah.
What is this, like 2 years ago? What's happening? Since when do we swap early off a map?
It's a GoTV thing. It's because, guys, the GoTV is on a delay, so if they get to change the map too early, then we won't really have a chance to catch up on the GoTV, and it'll just kind of like break for us early. That's annoying, but I mean, I don't think we missed that much. Like I said, Netto would have had
not a big surprise.
No, he would have had to like crab walk from us, spray five people. That obviously didn't happen, and they ended up losing the map. So that's just kind of the end of it here. That means we're gonna go on to the second map, which I believe is Inferno. Am I wrong? No, it's
Dust
2. You're right.
Yeah, I think Inferno is the third map if it goes to that. Although, judging from the first map and judging from just the ordinary, I guess the average level in both teams, it's probably not going to see a third map.
All right. Well, you're not giving us much hope, Vendetta, but I think you're right, actually. It seems like there's just a really big disconnect between the two teams at the moment. That happens. This is a qualifier. We want to find the best team to make it, and I think LGB has potential to be just not just like one of the best teams in Norway, but in the whole of Europe. So they're a really, really strong team. I would say like a top eight situation for LGB is not out of the question if they really put their mind to it. But we'll get back to that in a little bit, because before we move on, we do have to just go for a really quick break here as we do load up the second map and all that stuff on Dust 2. So just bear with us, guys. It won't be more than 5 minutes, and we'll be back with Dust 2 between LGB and Agent. So stay with us.